Good evening, students. Today we are going to learn about the surface heat treatments process for various materials. So in the previous webinar we have studied about the heat treatment process, that is depth heat treatment process, like annealing, tempering, hardening, normalizing. But in this webinar we are going to see how the surface heat treatment is done in various materials. So before that, what is meant by surface hardening? Surface hardening or case hardening is the same, which is the process of hardening the surface of metal object while allowing the metal deeper underneath to remain soft, thus forming a thin layer of harder material. Mostly turbine shaft, gears, spindles, automotive components like clutch, propeller shaft, they are usually hardened by surface hardening. Why surface hardening is necessary? These components like gear, shaft, spindle and are often too large to be uniformly hardened even on severe quenching. So purpose of surface hardening is to develop a hard surface with compressive residual stress to improve its wear resistance, to increase its fatigue life, and to avoid susceptibility to distortion and cracking. So surface hardening is very, very important for producing very wear resistance, corrosion resistance, and fatigue resistance of material. So now we are going to see what are the different types of surface hardening. The previous webinar we have studied about the types of bulk hardening like annealing, normalizing, hardening, tempering, and types of annealing. But in this webinar we are going to see surface hardenings. There are two types of surface hardening. One is thermal hardening, another one is thermochemical hardening. So first of all we are going to see about thermochemical hardening, then we will see about the thermal hardening. So before that, what are the advantages of case hardening? So if you harden the material with case hardening, corrosion resistance will be improved, wear resistance will be improved, and surface of appearance will become very good, very aesthetic looking. Then it will become non-stick surface and best lubricity enhancement, and also it will become a very improved electrical conductivity, solderability, and metallized plastic component surfaces. And also it will become shielding for electromagnetic and radio frequency radiation. So mainly for case hardening, we are going to use the quenching media like water and salt solution, that is known as brine, then cooling water, coolant oil, or cooled air, or turnoff furnace. Turnoff furnace means cooling itself in the furnace. So as I told, mainly two types of surface hardening, thermal hardening and thermochemical hardening. So first of all, we are going to see the thermochemical treatments. Nitriding, there are two types of nitriding, gas nitriding and liquid nitriding. Then carburizing, there are three types of carburizing: pack carburizing, gas carburizing, and liquid carburizing. Then carbonitriding, chroming, boronizing. Then thermal heat treatments consist of mainly induction hardening and flame hardening. So mainly low carbon steels are under the case hardening of carburizing, cyaniding, ferritic nitro carburizing, and carbonitriding. Then alloy steels are subjected to nitriding, iron nitriding, and tool steels are under the subjection of titanium carbide, boriding, salt nitriding, iron nitriding as and gas nitriding. And stainless steel is mainly subjected to gas nitriding, titanium carbide, iron nitriding, and ferritic nitrocarburizing. So these are the different case hardenings which are produced in the different types of steels. So this is the photocopy of case hardening for gear material. So first of all, it is under the heat treatment, that is heating inside the furnace or heating by flame hardening. So bulk materials like spur gear, which is under the flame hardening. So after the case hardening, the steel structures will become martensite microstructure. So this diagram will indicate micrograph of martensite and austenite. So all the materials after case hardening will get this structure. So first of all, under the category of thermochemical hardening, first of all, we are going to see carburizing. So carburizing is also referred to case hardening. It is a heat treatment process that produces the surface which is resistant to wear while maintaining toughness and strength of the core. So in this carburizing, the furnace which is used for this carburizing is a pit furnace or sealed atmospheric furnace. So first of all, we are going to see the first type of carburizing, that is pack carburizing. So this is the diagram for pack carburizing. In the pack carburizing, the pit furnace is used for this type of process. Before that, first of all, the component to be case hardened is placed inside the furnace. This furnace consists of the testing place, then the furnace will be surrounded by the activated charcoal. Then the heat is supplied to the furnace by means of electrically or flame hardening. So parts to be carburized is placed inside the furnace, then heating is to be done. After that, this component will be taken away from the furnace, then it is immediately quenched by means of any coolant media like cooling water, coolant oil, cooled air, like that. So this type of pack carburizing furnace will be manufactured by sealed steel container consists of activated charcoal. So carbon monoxide gas will be allowed to flow around the component while the heat treatment is applied. So because of this heat treatment as well as the flow of gas, this component to be case hardened will get the layer of carbon around the structure. So because of this case hardening, some thickness of layer will be formed after the heat treatment. So it will protect and it will create the hardened surface of outer surface. So the material will become very hardened. So during the pack carburizing, some chemical reactions will be done. So the charcoal produces the barium carbonate. This barium carbonate will be dissipated, barium oxide and carbon dioxide, because of the high heat. So it will dissociate the carbon dioxide. Then carbon dioxide react with carbon will produce carbon monoxide. This carbon monoxide will react with the component and produce ferrous carbide and carbon dioxide. Thus the case hardened will be produced on the outer surface of the component. So back carburizing, the temperature produced, the temperature applied for this back carburizing is 900 to 950 degrees Celsius for 6 to 8 hours. After that, the component will be taken away from the furnace and cooled at room temperature, and reactions will be done. Because of these reactions, the ferrous carbide will be produced and it will form around the component of the material to be case hardened. So this is the pack carburizing. So because of this pack carburizing, the interstitial solid solution will be produced. So the carbon atoms will be placed in between the iron atoms. So interstitial solid solution will be produced. Because of this, in a heat treatment, grind refining will be produced so that the component will get case hardened, and we can use these case hardened materials for many machining processes. Second one is gas carburizing. So in the case of pack carburizing, the solid material like charcoal, barium carbonate has been used. But in the second case of carburizing, that is gas carburizing, the gas will be used for producing the hardened surface. So this diagram will indicate the process of gas carburizing. In this type of gas carburizing, one tank is used. This tank containing carburizing gas. This carburizing gas will be allowed to flow through the pipeline, and flow meter and needle valve is used to control the gas flow of gas. So this gas will be flowed to this container. This container consists of the component to be case hardened. So the carburizing gas will flow through the container and it will create the component to be case hardened. At the same time, the heating will be done by means of this electrical furnace. So this electrical, by means of this electrical heaters, the heating will be given. At the same time, gas is also allowed to flow this type of holes. So the component will be uniformly case hardened because of using this fan. So some reactions will be done. The gas which is used for this gas carburizing is carbon monoxide, and the temperature used for this gas carburizing is 900 degrees Celsius, and this 900 degrees Celsius temperature will be maintained for 3 to 4 hours. Because of this, heated in contact with high carbon like hydrocarbon like methane, ethane or propane, it carries gases like nitrogen, hydrogen and carbon monoxide. So carbon monoxide will react with ferrous and hydrogen, and it will produce ferrous carbide and H2O, that is water. Then this ferrous carbide will form around the surface of the material, and it will produce some layer. So because of this layer, case hardening will be done at the outer surface of the material. So this advantages of this gas carburizing is it is suitable for mass production, decreased time for operation, low labor cost and low floor size. Then third one is liquid carburizing. So liquid carburizing, so in this liquid carburizing, the barium chloride and sodium cyanide is used. So this liquid carburization is also known as cyaniding. So in this cyaniding process, some container will be used. So this container will consist of the liquid bath of barium chloride and sodium cyanide, and also the component to be case hardened is depth into the container. So it will be placed inside the chemical bath of this container. So the chemical reactions will be created. At the same time, heating is also done by use of heaters. So some reactions will be created. Because of these reactions, barium cyanide and ferrous carbide will be produced. So these reactions will consist of barium chloride react with sodium cyanide, and it will give barium cyanide and sodium chloride. Then this barium cyanide will be dissipated, and it will produce a dissociation of carbon and barium cyanide. So because of this carbon, the carbon will placed around the surface of the material, and it will form some layer, and thus the case hardening will be done around the material. So this is the liquid gas, liquid carburization. Then last one is nitriding. So this diagram will indicate the process of nitriding. In the nitriding process, ammonia gas is used for producing the layer of case hardening. So in this diagram, ammonia tank is used. So the ammonia tank will consist of ammonia gas. So at the same time, this is the furnace. In the furnace, the component to be case hardened is placed by means of this shell. So, and also electrical heaters are also used for heating the component. So at the same time, ammonia gas will flow through these pipes, and it will enter this container for creating the nitride form of case hardening. So because of the heating and flow of ammonia gas, some reactions will be created. Because of these reactions, some form of nitride will be produced around the surface of the material. After producing the nitride, so the remaining gas will flow through this pipeline, and it will collect some, it will be collected by this bubbler. So this is the process of cyaniding, that is liquid carburizing. So the component to be case hardened is placed inside the container, and it will consist of the chemical bath of barium chloride and sodium cyanide. So last one is carbonitriding. So as name itself, simultaneously a carbon monoxide and ammonia gas is flow through the furnace. So in this furnace, so the component is placed in the part of this furnace. So at the same time, the two gases, that is carbon monoxide and ammonia, will be allowed to flow through this green color pipeline, and it will enter the furnace. At the same time, heating will be applied by means of the electrical heaters. So the carbon gas and nitrogen gas will be formed because of the reaction. So both carbon gas, carbon and nitrogen will be formed around the surface of the material. So case hardening will be thus maintained. So this is the another diagram. This is the free body diagram of carbonitriding. So it will consist of three zones: preheating zone, carbonitriding zone, and quenching zone. So by means of belt conveyor, the component to be case hardened will be entered inside the furnace. First, it will be preheated by means of neutral gas. Then it will be heated by means of carburizing gas and ammonia gas, that is carbon monoxide gas and ammonia gas. So because of this second zone, the carbon and nitrogen will be formed around the surface of the material. Then this material will be enter into the quenching zone. In this quenching zone, cooling gas will be allowed to cool the component. After that, it will be case hardened and it will be taken away from this furnace. So these are all the comparison of different case hardening processes. So because of a nitrating process, we can achieve 70 RC, that is Rockwell hardness number. And we can create the case hardening with the thickness of 0.5 to 0.8 mm. For carburizing, we can get 60 RC number, and we can produce the thickness layer of the layer thickness is 0.025 to 4 mm. Then third one is carbonitrating. By means of this carbonitrating, we can achieve 70 RC number, and we can produce the thickness of 0.07 to 0.5 mm. So next one is thermal hardening. So far we have studied about the thermochemical hardening. Now we are entering into thermal hardening. So there are two types of thermal hardening. One is flame hardening, another one is induction hardening. So first one is flame hardening. In this flame hardening, first of all, the component to be case hardened will enter into the heaters. So by means of this heater, the case hardening will be done. Then immediately, by means of this nozzles, the water will be sprayed. So first of all, by using the flame, the heating will be done. Immediately after heating, the quenching will be created by means of this water jets. So thus the flame hardening will be produced. So quenching medium is cooling water by means of this water jet nozzles. So this is also the another diagram for flame hardening. So by means of this nozzle, so both heating torch and water jet will be connected with one equipment. So after producing the heating by means of this oxyacetylene flame, that is gas welding, then immediately the quenching also done by means of this water jet. Because of this heating, after immediately the cooling, the workpiece will be case hardened. So no chemicals, no gases, no liquid will be used in the case of this flame hardening. Only heating and quenching will be produced for giving the case hardening. So it is the difference between thermochemical hardening and thermo hardening. So thermo hardening, only heating and quenching will be used. So this is the photocopy for the flame hardening for using the gears. Then second one of thermal hardening is induction hardening. So in the induction hardening, heating will be done because of this electrical coil. So because of this electrical coil, instead of flame torches which will be used for flame hardening, the electrical heat winding, this electrical coil will be used for producing the heating of the component. So first of all, the heating will be done by means of this coil. Then immediately quenching will be done because of this water jet nozzles. So immediately heating and quenching will be used for getting the case hardening. Because of this heating and quenching, the component will be case hardened. So this is the diagram for another one diagram for induction hardening. So for heating, electrical coils are used. For cooling, the water jet nozzles are used. So these are all the two types of thermo hardening. So in the advantages of induction hardening is it is very effective for surface hardening of plain carbon steel having 0.35 to 0.7% of carbon. The salient features of induction hardening are heat the surface to temperature above the austenitic region, then the core does not get heated, the structure remains unaltered, then fast heating and short holding time, after that quenching will be produced by means of water jets. So these are all the case hardened materials: gears, spindles, camshaft, and different types of tools like drill bits and some levers. These are all the case hardened materials. Because of this case hardening, these type of materials will become hardened, and we can increase the life of these components because of the case hardening. So far we have studied about two types of case hardenings. One is thermo hardening and another one is thermochemical hardening. Thermochemical hardening consists of carburizing, nitriding, carbonitriding, and cyaniding. The thermo hardening consists of flame hardening and induction hardening. So I hope you can easily understand the type of case hardening, and you can very much awareness about the case hardening of different carbon steels and other materials. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for watching the video. Make sure you've subscribed so that you can get the regular updates. Use the feedback link in the description to get your certificate. Thank you.